Now, you got shot down your first deployment.
I did.
To Vietnam.
I did.
And you survived, obviously, and you evaded the enemy, and you got picked up. Do you think that bolstered your confidence?
Yeah, I don't know. I don't want to talk too much about my own psychology because I've had, you know, after I got back from being a prisoner, we had to have psychological evaluations and stuff. And the psychiatrist saying, well, you know, what are some of the things you enjoy? Well, you know, I was a forest firefighter and I enjoyed that. And I did a little college, rode some rodeo and I like to ride motorcycles. And the guy, oh, okay. Would you have a death? No, I don't have a death wish. I don't know. There's something about psychological makeup of some people that they do okay in that type of situation. You know, that would come all the way to how I've adjusted since I got back from Vietnam. And I go into a lot of that in my first book of the trials and tribulations that I faced and what today would be called PTSD. But, you know, I got through all of that. And I tell some of the ways that I did that. And I think I'm semi-fine today. So, you know, whatever mental mindset got me through those combat operations on that second tour also got me through first tour. I was shot down over the middle of Laos. I had injuries to my neck. I rode an ejection seat out, a very short parachute ride down. We were crashing through the trees by the time I punched out, so I got a partial chute deployment and I hit the ground. But I got picked up and taken to hospital in Thailand and was in the hospital for a while and then back to the unit. And as soon as I got back to the unit, I was up reporting to the flight surgeon and say, hey, I got to get back on flight status. I got to go fly. So, yeah, who knows what's there. But I was enthusiastic to fly my missions on the first tour. And after a break back to the States and back to Vietnam, I had to fight because the U.S. was withdrawing so rapidly. I had to fight at every level to get assigned to a unit still in combat. So maybe there's a little Duffy inside of me. I don't know. I wanted to get back into the fight.
Now, as you're seeing this massive buildup, I mean, you're seeing tanks on the ground.
Right.
This has got to change your viewpoint a little bit. It seems like everyone would say, oh, something massive is coming.
Yeah, the massive wasn't there for some reason. Something's coming. I think somewhere in the back of my mind was, well, whatever it is, we'll handle it. You know, if the enemy comes out of the woods, we got B-52s and all these airstrikes, and we'll just annihilate them in place, similar to what was done up at Quezon in 1968 when they put Quezon under siege. We just bomb, and really caused the enemy a lot of damage. So I think that thought was there. Yeah, there must have been some concern because some of the attacks, the enemy attacked Route 19, which was between our base at Pleiku and the coast, and they closed Route 19. We got involved in a bunch of operations down there. So we were cut off in the highlands. There was no road transport coming to our base at Camp Holloway near Pleiku. All our supplies had to come in C-130s on the runway. Engineer crews came in there to improve the PSP runway and make it better. There was some talk that was done because if the situation got bad enough, they'd have to get in and extract us and get us out of there. I don't know. Somehow we still had our routine of daily
right.
Go fly combat missions and come home at night and get drunk and get up the next morning and go do it all again.
How long would you fly for in the day?
Oh, gosh. I don't know, 4, 5, 6 hours. But the day was longer because we would take off in the morning, and if we didn't have a mission right away, we'd go stand by somewhere at Dock To or at the FOB pad, the SOG pad. So there was a lot of downtime waiting.
Just waiting? Would you wait in your bird?
Yeah, well, we'd wait next to, not sitting in the bird, next to the bird. Sometimes we'd play a little cards, but we'd be right there so mm-hmm. we could launch within 2 minutes. That was our routine when we put the SOG teams in, too. We'd put the team in, we'd go back to usually Dock To, and we'd just sit there and wait, because if the team got in trouble, we had to be immediately available for them. On any given day, there was some downtime just sitting, waiting for lunch. Once the activity started picking up in the Easter Offensive, though, it was a lot of flying, refueling. That, if you recall in my first book, by the time we got there, now this is going to be 3 weeks after the Charlie battle, boy, it was all day. I mean, I did 3 rotations into combat before noon. It was on my 3rd rotation into combat that I got shot down, and that was before we got to noon.